In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Brethren, let us rejoice in the Lord for His great love and care for all mankind which He showed toward us from the very beginning of our existence. This economia of salvation of mankind is especially reflected in today's parable which we heard during the reading of the Holy Gospel. Christ is telling this parable for a reason, because in many times we hear or read in the Holy Gospel that chief Pharisees or scribes of the or rulers of the people of Israel, how many times they used to blame Christ, saying he's a Samaritan, he's got a devil in him, he's the Lord of evil spirit who casts away evil spirit. And nevertheless, Christ himself made so many miracles, so many people he healed, and also brought a good tidings of the Holy Gospel. They always blamed him and were blind. And then Christ is telling them this parable of the vineyard. This parable is meant especially for them, because from a certain time, God the Father planted the vineyard of the holy nations. He called them to a special aim that they will bring to the whole world the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ. He hedged this vineyard with a fence. That means he gave them commandments, he gave them divine laws, and also he built a tower in the middle of this vineyard, which is nothing else than the holy temple in which the sacrifice was being brought to every Saturday, every Sabbath, to the Almighty One. And he commanded them, Lord the Father, he prepared everything for them and gave them this vineyard and commanded them, take care of it. So only thing they have to do, they had to bring us a due date, good fruits. And these good fruits, they are supposed to be the respecting of the commandments and through their obedience toward the Lord. And at certain time, God the Father is sending prophets to ask them for the fruits of the vineyard, for the fruits of their obedience. Instead of that, they got angry seeing prophets of the Almighty One. Some of them they killed, some of them they stoned to death, some of them they beaten up. Then Lord, in His compassion and long-suffering, sent again even more prophets. And likewise, to these prophets happened the same as to the first one. And again, God the Father doesn't destroy them. That doesn't destroy these wicked people who deserve actually to be punished for their disobedience. But He is sending them His only begotten Son, saying maybe they will reverence Him, will respect Him. But the workers of the vineyard, seeing the son of the master of the vineyard, told among themselves, "Here is the inheritant. Let's kill him and we'll inherit his vineyard." And they took him out of the vineyard and killed him there. These words are actually prophetical, because that actually happened to Christ. He was brought out of the Jerusalem, and there he was killed. And Christ is asking them, what should do the master of the vineyard to these wicked people? Christ asking this question for good reason, because He is not the one who is punishing them, but He wants them to judge themselves for their wickedness. And they themselves bring the punishment, saying the master of the vineyard will kill the wretched people, and the vineyard will be bring and will give it to others who will bring good fruits in good time. And if we see in the history of the church, that actually happened not long time after Christ was crucified and resurrected from the death. Because in the 70 years after Christ, during the dominion of Titus, the holy city of Jerusalem was completely destroyed, and the all holy nation was scattered all around the world. And their mission was given to others, to the heathen who accepted the word of Holy Gospel, and multiply this word. What lesson should we learn from this parable today, brethren? Because we are the new Jerusalem. We are the new vineyard. We are new workers, other workers to whom Christ gave this vineyard to bring good fruits in due time. And many times we hear that some people saying, "I'm proud to be Orthodox." But Orthodox is not about pride, it's about lowliness of heart. And we have to take heed of our attitude about ourselves, about other people. Do not do the same mistake which the holy nation has done. Otherwise we may end up the same fate as they did. So, brethren and sisters in Christ, let us be careful and keep commandments of our Lord Jesus Christ, and especially love our God from our heart and from our whole mind, and love our brethren around us, and not despise those who are not part of this vineyard, but look at them with compassion, and pray, Lord, that He may bring them also to our community. May Lord our God have mercy on us all. Amen.
Amen. Amen.